When maple juice was first introduced, like I also said in the lecture, this was like a big success because it offered these two simple functions, map and reduce, and everything else would be handled by the processing environment, so the implementation, for instance, like Hadoop. So now with this, data scientists could just write these two functions, and then without bothering about fault tolerance or efficient processing, the system would execute what they want. However, if you're going to a bit more complicated tasks, for instance, n-cram mining or joins in MapReduce, then you see that you have to think carefully how you're arranging MapReduce in order to achieve your task, particularly if you're looking at something like SQL, right, which is easy to use to compute joins and group by and aggregation. Now with MapReduce, you have a bit harder task. However, this was not the main goal to replace a database system by MapReduce. Still, people were a bit unhappy at some point then because MapReduce was very low level for normal users. It was quite difficult to make more complicated applications out of MapReduce. So PIG and the query language PIG Latin was one of these approaches that would build something on top of MapReduce to make life easier for developers. Here the idea is to propose a query language, PIG Latin. You can write the queries in. It is like a data flow language, not really like something like SQL, but we will see some examples later on. And these queries are then compiled, so transformed, into sequences, if needed, of MapReduce jobs. Here, for instance, we have a simple PIG Latin program. First, we are loading some file, some relation that we call input here, input file, and we say that we want to name the individual columns, let's say it's a comma separated file, as XYZ. And then we name this data set A, and now we can apply a filter on A. And the filter is given by the predicate X has to be strictly larger than 5. And finally, this B that we defined here as a subset of A is written to output. Now, when you're writing this PIG Latin script, or these commands, and you're submitting this to PIG, then of course it is parsed, and then there's a logical query optimization going on, similar to what we know from database systems. And in the end, there's a MapReduce job, or multiple of them started. And in the end, you can find the results then in HDFS. So basically, this is only like a way that makes it easier to write MapReduce programs. However, the implementation or the realization is still done in MapReduce, specifically Hadoop MapReduce. So you can use the cron shell to play around with PIG. You can start then writing these sequences of commands, as we have seen on the previous slide, and then hitting enter, and then this will be started as a MapReduce job. There's like a data model that's called a nested data model. This is not what we know from database system because this is able to violate the first normal form of these traditional database systems because you can have these nested relations, right? And this is not allowed in, as we know, in traditional relational database systems. Without going into details, yeah, you have simple types, int, tuple, char array, and so on. You have tuples, which are sequences or fields. It's a non-typed system, so you have no schema necessarily. You can have a bag or a map and so on. And this is like only some highlights of the data model. You can execute joins. For instance, here we're loading two data sets, A and B. And now see how easy it is to write a join. We're just defining we want to join A. And here this is the join key inside A with B. And here's the key inside B, which should be used for the join. And as we can see here, this takes the first here and the second one and tries to create the, or match the join predicate for inequality in this case. There also support for outer joins and so on. So now this, if you're looking at this, effort here, writing it down in this language compared to doing this natively in MapReduce. This is a big time saver for writing the queries. You can have data with associated schema. For instance, if you have here a text file and it follows a schema and you know about it, then you can load this data set that we call here people by specifying the schema, in this case an ID, which is an integer, and a name, which is a character array. And likewise also here for another data set. There were several commands in PicLatin, load store we have seen, or dump, filter flatten for each, and so on, join, and also group or co-group, and also cross for cross product, and limit operator order by. So this is like very similar, but not quite the same as SQL offers, because the nature of the language is totally different than SQL. It's not a declarative language, but it is a sequence of commands. Does not mean that it cannot be optimized in the end by the PIC environment, but the way you're writing queries is different how you would do it in SQL. So here's an example in PicLatin for computing word count. We have seen how we can do this already in MapReduce. So we had to specify a map, which is parsing the input lines, and then we had to emit these individual terms to the reducer. So we had to use the term as the key and emitting a one, and then the reducer is counting. Or we can do the same like idea of word count as well here in PicLatin, of course. First of all, we are loading a data set, or we describe that we want to load it. It's not loaded when we type it, but it will be in the end executed in MapReduce. So we're loading A, and then we apply tokenization here on these input lines. In the end, we're getting terms. Then we remove whitespace by filtering out those terms which match this expression here. Then in the end, we are grouping by term. And you see this here is exactly where we had to use the emit in the map phase based on the term so that the reducer can aggregate, right? And here we can just write it like this. As you can imagine, then the realization of this would not look different than what we would do in a manual way by defining map and reduce functions. Now in the end, here for the aggregation, we say that we want to count for individual groups, where we group by term, as we say here. We are counting, and if you do this in SQL, you would do something similar, right? You say you want to select a term and the count from some table group by term, so getting the frequencies. This is similarly done here. In the end, we also want to order as a final step these information by the frequency. So we have ascending order. So we have the small frequency first and then larger and larger. So now if you're doing this and you're starting this, then you will see that MapReduce is then in the end in the started, there will be first some query optimization starting, and then the MapReduce plan information will be emitted. In particular, also the number of records and bytes written. And what is also interesting, because I said already that PIC in general can produce multiple MapReduce jobs, and multiple MapReduce jobs are connected, forming a DAG, a directed acyclic graph. And here you have the MapReduce job information put together with information how they are connected. So you see, this is like a multiple MapReduce job for doing this word count and sorting as we have specified on the previous slide. There's also a method called co-group, very briefly. So let's say you have here comma separated value file owners. You see you have person names and the cat they have. And what you want to do now is you grouping the owners relation to the table here by animal. And then you here with dump, you're just outputting the information. And then for this input table, you're getting this here as the output. So you see this is not really a group where you group by the animal and then you're aggregating or you're counting. Here you still have in the in the other field next to the key, term or the key that we used for grouping, you have here the entire tuple that is causing this, or this belongs to this group cat. So we have here Adam cat and Alice cat. Right? It's only one example of one of these functionalities in Pig. You can also co-group two tables. Here we have owners, and here we have the individual pets information. So you see we have a cat called Paws and a cat called Whiskers. So now we can co-group these. And again, we can do this, or we do this by the command sequence in Pig. Here we specify co-group the owners by animal and the pets by animal. And then what we get here is like a group cats, or group cat, and owners are listed, and also the pets are listed, the cats with the names, right? So this is of course not the same as if you executing a join in SQL between these two tables based on the cat name, or the cat, or the animal type, right? It's not the same. You can also have user-defined functions, like we know from Postgres or from a relational database system. You can do the same here in Pig. You can implement some code in Java, registering this code as a user-defined function, and then you can call this as well in Pig. As I mentioned, of course, when you're writing a sequence of these instructions, it does not mean that MapReduce has to evaluate them one after the other. Right? But it's still not the same as writing a declarative query in SQL. So still having this instruction sequence, Pig, so the runtime, can still optimize the query, for instance, pushing filters down, as we know already from database systems, or eliminating unnecessary information, which is like a projection, as we know from a database system, which was also used there in logical query optimization. In general, if you're looking at MapReduce and looking at multiple MapReduce jobs, you can also optimize the execution order if there are no dependencies between the jobs as dictated by the DAG behind the individual jobs. And this also in particular allows reusing stored outputs or of previous jobs. So now, why was it developed, Pig? I mentioned this earlier. It should make life easier to write non-trivial code, or achieving non-trivial application logic, so the program, beyond simple map and reduce. However, there was like a statement from a Twitter engineer. Of course, this is only one statement from one Twitter engineer, and the statement is already quite old. When this was like a big hype topic. Now, let's see what he or she said. So writing a Pig script is 5% of the code than a native MapReduce job that you have to specify. And writing takes about 5% of the time. Now, of course, if it's all new to you now, as we have introduced very quickly now, and you have to do a join, but then you have to just find out there's a join command, and then you're doing the join or the group by, you don't have to go down and writing MapReduce functionality. However, it's still good to know what's going on, because if you're just writing some code in this easy fashion, and you're not thinking about what really goes on in the Hadoop implementation, then the query might not be so effective, so efficient. And this is also what the engineer says, that however, queries typically take between 110 to 150% of the time to execute compared to a native MapReduce job implementation. So you're buying like a worse performance by more productivity when you're designing the script. And of course, also if it's only a few lines of code for the script, it's also easier to maintain and it's easier to see what's going on compared to looking at one large MapReduce implementation, right? The job implementation. As I mentioned earlier a couple of times, PIC-Latin is like a sequence of operations, instructions. This is not comparable in that regard to SQL, which is of course purely declarative. You're just specifying which results you want and not giving the order how this should be implemented. However, still in PIC-Latin or in PIC, there's of course potential to optimize these queries given in PIC-Latin. So one more comparison, PIC versus relational database management systems. It's still not comparable and also not aimed to be comparable. Having PIC is not making a database system out of MapReduce. It's still not really about schema or hard enforcement of schemas. In PIC you have schema at runtime, and even there it's only optional. You can have all kinds of sources, and basically whatever MapReduce can load, you can also process using this PIC. PIC is just the easier used language on top of MapReduce. So it's still not really the replacement for a database system. So after PIC was released or proposed, there was also another approach called Hive. Hive was what they claimed to be a relational database management system for big data. Still, it was running on Hadoop like PIC was doing, but at least it had now a query language which was similar to SQL, so it was declarative and not just a data flow language like PIC Latin was. So this was originating from Facebook and was then made an Apache project. And indeed, as you see here, although it did not fully support SQL 92 standard, this is pretty much what you know or what you have seen already from SQL. And there were many other different projects proposed. At some point, of course, like things like PIC and Hive, they got over the time replaced by approaches like Spark, right, which was also then pretty much the following up of MapReduce, which is offering also extensions for SQL and so on. But this was like a big big trend then to build more fancy tools on top of MapReduce framework. Yeah, as a summary, we have discussed MapReduce as a programming paradigm. Of course, underlying this paradigm, there is infrastructure implemented, like Hadoop is one implementation next to the native one proposed by Google, which was not released then, of course. It is able to process large amounts of data in a batched fashion. And the core about MapReduce, as the name tells you already, are two functions, map and reduce. And they tell, or they're describing, how data is processed and aggregated. Particularly, that means that these two, or in particular the map, tells how data is flowing through the system. So how data is coming from the map tasks to the reduce task. Now, if you want to implement, as we have seen, algorithm in MapReduce, you have to think carefully, how do you emit data in the map, and how do you, in the end, aggregate data as a reducer, and what else you have to do in terms of customizations. So we have discussed multiple application scenarios and algorithms on that. We also briefly discussed that MapReduce jobs can be connected so to entire workflows, like also what PIC would in the end output, depending on, of course, on the specification of the query. We have seen that there was an invention called PIC, which would be able to, or would enable to write more complicated queries, which would then be automatically translated to MapReduce jobs and should make life of data scientists and engineers easier without the hassle to implement more complicated functionality only based on these map and reduce functions.